Hello friends, myself Mahavir Goswami, Principal BN Convent Senior Secondary School Sangria. I have been teaching English language and literature for 20 years. First of all, I welcome you all on this virtual class, in the virtual class that is meant for spoken English. As you know, language is very essential for communication, and we are learning English as a second language in India. So during this lockdown period, I want to use this free time for me as well as for you. First of all, I want to tell you, my dear students, that you should use your free time, use your this very precious time for improving anything, any skill. As you know, skill is a special ability to do something gained through practice. So nowadays this is very important, that I am also improving my skill this online class. So this is my first experience also, that I want to give you a lesson about spoken English, because English is very important not only in India but also in the world. As you know very well, that we live in India and Hindi is our mother tongue, or we can say our first language, and English is our second language. So we must command both the languages. So language, the first and basic quality of the language is to communicate. So communicate with others, this is the basic quality of the language. So today I want to start my online or virtual class with this language to tell you something about the skill. Just speaking is a skill, like, you know, playing is a skill, singing is a skill, and speaking in English is also a skill. So just I want to tell you for this skill, that just today's virtual class we will start with a sentence. That is very important, the sentence is, because you know spoken English is not so difficult. This is, as I told you, that this is a skill. So in the skill, I start my virtual class with this sentence. This is very important sentence, and I will suggest you and I will request you that you will use this sentence as your motto, as your motivation. If you want to learn swimming, you will have to plunge into water. Tairna seekhne ke liye chhalang lagana jaruri hai. This is like that. So in the same manner, in this class, we are going to start our spoken English with introduction. As you know, when we meet something, when we meet somebody or anybody, so first of all we introduce ourselves, and just we greet first of all, we greet each other, and our conversation will begin with greetings. So today I also want to greet you all. Good afternoon, everyone. So, and you know, greeting, when we greet each other in different time, then we use different words for greeting in the different time. For example, when we meet anybody or somebody in the morning, when we say, good morning, sir, good morning, ma'am, good morning, friend, good morning. We say good morning, and before 12 noon, we say good morning, and just right 12 o'clock, then we say good noon, sir, and after 12 means in the day, we say after 12 we say good afternoon. We say good afternoon, and when in British context, after 4 o'clock, if they meet after 4 o'clock, they say good evening. But in our Indian context, as you know, in India, most of the Indians use British English as their second language. As you know, British ruled over India for a very long period, and in India we study British English. So in Indian context, after 5 o'clock we say good evening, good evening sir, good evening everyone, like that. So when we are meeting in the evening, and anybody, then we say good evening sir, good evening ma'am. And when we depart, if we depart in the day, when we depart in the day, we say good day sir, good day ma'am, like that. If we depart in the evening, then we say good evening. First we greet, good evening sir, good evening ma'am. And after the meeting, when we depart, then we say good night. Then we say good night, have a nice day, and have sweet dreams, and have a good night. So this is the way we can say, we speak at the time of meeting and at the time of depart. Because greeting is very important. Greeting is very important. And sometimes, sometimes we use a formal greeting, like when we meet somebody and formally, then we use a formal greeting, that is, how do you do? This is a formal greeting, how do you do? So this is greeting, and after greeting, just introduction. So most of the time when we greet and introduce yourself and get introduction of the person whose we are meeting at the time. So for example, I give a special introduction. For example, myself, Robert, and just I want to introduce myself, and my introduction is like this. Hi, my name is Robert. I'm from Australia. I'm 25. I'm a computer programmer. I'm married. I'm interested in music. My favorite colors are black and white. Like this. This is an introduction of Robert. Now you can introduce yourself in the real name and real interest and real hobbies. Just you want to introduce yourself, and after greeting, your talk, your conversation will begin. So in this way, as a second language, English is very easy and very fantastic language. So I will suggest you that every day we will discuss a topic through video, and we will try to learn this second language as a second language in India. This is our target language, and this is the second language of India, and it has got a reputation of international language. This is used as an international communication language. So that's all about this greeting and introduction. Thank you so much. I think you have listened me very carefully, and you will try to improve this. Okay, thank you. Bye bye.